Hi, welcome to Online Appliance Tech. Let's go shopping and look for some refrigerators. So this is an LG refrigerator. It has the ice and water in the door. And then this fridge is a single evaporator with the R600 compressor. The problems they have with this fridge a lot is the shelf's fallen and the ice maker and cooling issues after a year and a half due to the R600 compressor failure. So this is one I would probably pass on. Okay, right here we have a nice GE refrigerator, four-door smart, French door. The asking price for this guy is around $3,000, anywhere up to $4,000. It is a dual evaporator R600 compressor, so I wouldn't recommend it just because of the way it's made. The R600 compressors are having a lot of problems. Looks like on the reviews on this unit, they just have a lot of issues with the delivery and just common issues with all the way around. The ratings are not that bad though, but me personally, I would stay away from the ice maker door and the R600 compressors. Okay, so here we have another GE French door refrigerator. This is actually a single evaporator R34A refrigerant, and they only have the water on the side here, no ice or water in the door, so more or less problems that may occur with the ice in the door. I did check out the reviews online, and this one didn't have that many cooling problems or problems at all, so I would definitely recommend this one over the other GE refrigerator. Okay, so here we have the LG French door 2.51 cube. This is a single evaporator and it has the craft ice. Common problems with this unit being an R602 is the compressor failure and the craft ice maker in the freezer. So those are two major common problems we're having or seeing and complaints. Okay, so here we have the Samsung 28.2 cube French door. This is a dual evaporator R600 unit. Problems I see with this unit a lot is the compressor failure between 6 months to a year and a half. It is, like I said, an R600. Also, ice maker problems and defrost problems. So this is one I would definitely not recommend. Okay, so here we have the French door KitchenAid refrigerator. As we can see, we have no ice and water in the door, so that's great, no problems. And then we have the single evaporator R34A refrigerant, and this is a counter depth unit. It has water in the door, and I believe it has an ice maker in the freezer. This is definitely one I would recommend, just being because of the repair cost is fairly cheap too, if you ever did have to have it repaired. And mostly the common problems is just a relay or some type of thermal fuse or thermostat for the defrost. So the price is not that bad for what you get. Okay, so here we have another Samsung counter depth refrigerator. This is a dual evaporator R600. I've never mentioned in the beginning of the video, but the reason I recommend single evaporator over dual evaporator, because anytime you have a evaporator in the fresh food department, they do tend to cause a lot of micro leaks, meaning freon leaks. And once you have a contaminated system, more than likely you're going to have to replace the compressor, filter, dryer, and so forth. And then that's kind of a high pricey repair. And even though if it's under warranty, just having it worked on left and right is really not a good way to go. Okay, and once again we have another Samsung. This is kind of like the one that we looked at the beginning of the video. This one is a dual evaporator R600 also, so you know my opinion on these. I pretty much would stay away from these just because of the problems that will come or occur in the future. It's just really not worth the headache. Also, these ice makers here that are on the upper left are called Ice Masters, but they have a lot of problems. What happens is the airflow gets between the housing of the fridge where the fresh food is and up into the evaporator of the ice maker, and then it causes it to freeze over. So many ice maker problems there. So here we have the Whirlpool side by side. This is a good refrigerator. The price is fairly right on. So it's a single evaporator R34A compressor. So I don't see many problems with these. So yeah, I would definitely recommend this one over any other refrigerator in the side-by-side. Okay, here we have the GE refrigerator side-by-side. The price is not that bad on this one either. This one is a single evaporator R34A refrigerant, so this will be definitely one I would recommend if you're looking for the GE product. So yeah, this is usually don't have that many problems I see through the repairs. Okay, so here we have another LG. This is the top and bottom. It has a single evaporator, however, the R600 compressor. So these tend to have a lot of compressor failure problems within a year to 2 years of lifespan, even though they do have the 10-year warranty on the compressor and 5 years for the seal system repair. It's just a big headache to come downstairs one morning and have your food defrosted. So I wouldn't recommend this one. And here's another Samsung, same thing, single, actually this is the dual evaporator R600. So you know my thoughts on the Samsung, the R600, actually this is a single evaporator. But this is one I would definitely probably pass on myself. However, it's nice and nice shelves, but they do have a couple remotes. Okay, so here we have the Samsung Bespoke 30.1 cubic foot smart refrigerator. I did check out the reviews online. They are having a lot of cooling issues, a couple shelf problems. Like I said, this is a dual evaporator R600 and prone to have the seal system problems, even though this unit does have a 10-year warranty on the compressor and a 5-year seal system. It's like I always say, why would you want to wake up in the morning and have your food spoiled because you have a product that's going to have to be repaired quite a bit. So I definitely would not recommend this one, even though it's super nice and has a lot of space. Just make sure you have a good warranty on it. Okay, so here we have another French door LG refrigerator. This is a single evaporator R600 unit. So I wouldn't recommend it just because it is a R600 compressor and they tend to fail within between a year to two after purchase. Also, the ice maker problem in the door, they do have a lot of those issues. I wouldn't recommend this refrigerator. Okay, so here we have the Whirlpool French door refrigerator. I do recommend this refrigerator. This is kind of the same thing as the KitchenAid, same family. This is a single evaporator R34A refrigerant, and these tend to last anywhere from 5 to 10 years without repairs. And then most of the time when the repairs, with the repairs, they're very minor. So this is definitely one I would recommend. Okay, so if you are looking for the GE product, this is probably the one I would recommend for the French door. This is a dual evaporator. However, it is R34A. I don't see many Freon leaks with this product. The only problem I really see is the fresh fruit evaporator fan problem. So yeah, I mean, I would recommend this over a Samsung or LG that does have ice in the door, but I don't see too many common problems with this unit, so yeah, I guess I would recommend it definitely over the other products. Okay, so here's the KitchenAid refrigerated French door. It is a R34A unit, dual evaporator, however, but I would definitely recommend this one over the LG or Samsung. I usually don't see no problems with these until 5 to 7 years. And when they do have issues with these, most of the time it is the fresh food evaporator problem with the evaporator fan or ice maker, but all in all, this is definitely a better product than any other name brand like LG or Samsung. You probably ask yourself, which one would I buy? If I went shopping, I would probably stick with the KitchenAid, Whirlpool, or GE product with a single evaporator with the R34A refrigerant. And the rest of them, in this case, I would... Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and please like and subscribe for more future tips and videos. Have a good day.